Now, I told you that my father is from Cameroon, but see, my siblings and I, we were raised in Detroit. And when everybody just gets silent and starts sitting down, we think something's about to pop off. And before we could get our escape route together, I had to ask one of my cousins, how come everybody is sitting down? And she whispered to me that they are sitting down because the Fon must be here. And if you don't know, the Fon is the chief of a Cameroonian village. And villagers have so much respect for who he is. Villagers have so much reverence for the position that he holds. Villagers have so much love for their leader that when he comes into their presence, they just sit down. And I don't know who I'm preaching to this morning, but the Bible says that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow. So when Jesus comes into your workplace, sit down. When Jesus comes into your relationship, sit down. When Jesus comes into your living room, sit down. Cease all previously scheduled activities. Shift all prior engagements and sit down in the presence of God. And I got three people amening, but if we're honest, we know that sitting down is easier said than done. It's difficult for us to sit down in the presence of God because we've been taught that our success is more dependent upon us than it is on God. And so we pace the floors of our bedrooms until the midnight hour. We 6 month, 2 year, 5 year, 10 year plan until our hands cramp. Because if we sit down, we have to acknowledge that we lack complete control over the outcome of our lives. If we sit down, we have to recognize that everything that we think depends on our gifts, our talents, and our skills could be managed by God. But can I let you in on a little secret, St. Mark's? You can have a seat today because Jesus can handle your to-do list.